Hi guys, this is Avinash Sharma, and in this session we will learn what are the SQL constraints. SQL constraints are the predefined rules of the SQL server which takes the data, validate the data and then store the data in the table. It means these constraints can be used for validating the data before actually storing that in the table. So these constraints ensure the accuracy and reliability of the data in the data. Suppose you are entering the data of employees in a table and you want a rule in that table that the employee whose age is greater than 40 should not be allowed in the table. This is the rule. So you can apply the rule in the table as a constraint. So what happens when you try to insert the data in the employee and whose age is greater than 40, then your system will reject that data. Types of SQL constraints. There are two types: column level and table level. In column level, we apply the constraint only one column. In table level, we can apply the constraints on multiple column. In column level, we have the not null, unique key, primary key, foreign key, check and default. So we will check all these constraints with practical on the SQL server. First of all, we check the not null constraint. The function of the not null is to, it does not allow null value in that column, which column is not null declared. So we check the table. We have a table that is the create table and demo not null. In this table, we have three fields: EMP ID, mobile number and city. But there is no constraint for now on these columns. So I have to apply on EMP ID, not null. It means if we enter the data in this table, then EMP ID column must have value. And important thing is, null is not a blank or space, it's a data type. So I have to declare this EMP ID not null. So this is the column label constant, say not null. This is the syntax. This is how you can declare any column not null. So for now, EMP ID is now not null. It means this EMP ID always require some data. Okay, I create this table. Table has been created. Okay, now I insert some data. So you can see in this statement we have only two column, mobile number and city, and two values. We are skipping the EMP ID. And when you skip the value and when you skip the column in a table, then system insert the null value in that column. But this EMP ID column is not null dict. What happens if I execute this statement? So I get the error, cannot insert the value, null value into EMP ID, because that column is declared as a not null. And in insert statement, I am not passing the value for that column. I'm skipping the EMP ID. So the system will try to insert the null value in the EMP ID column, but that is a not declared, so it is rejected. If I change, say, EMP ID, then 1, now. So now we check the data. So in EMP ID we have 1, but mobile number and city, these two columns are not declared as not null. It means these columns can accept the null value. Suppose I pass only EMP ID. So in this statement, I am taking only one EMP ID, that is the required, not null. And but the mobile number and city, I am skipping. So what happens? Row inserted, check the data, then EMP ID 1, but mobile number and city null, because these two columns are not null. And also you can check in the server management studio, the UI, say refresh and demo not null table in design mode. So you can see the last column allow null. So this check mark, which indicates that these columns can take the null value, but empid is unchecked. It means it's not null. So this way you can use the not null in the table. Now we come to the unique constraint. When you apply the unique constraint on any column, that column will maintain the unique value in that column and will not accept the duplicate value. Okay, we check the table. Suppose we have a create table and demo unique. So in this column we have empid, mobile number, city. EMP, this time we have a unique constraint. Other columns do not have any constraint. So I create this table and insert some data. Now I execute this statement. I check the data. We have empid with value 1 and mobile numbers and city. So this empid is declared as a unique column value. If I try to execute this statement again, then I get the error violation of unique constraint. This constant, this is the name of the constant SQL server created itself. Now cannot insert duplicate value in the object demo unique because of this constraint, unique constraint. If I change the value, I make it 2, then execute again and check the data again. So now empid, we have 2 value. So this is the unique value. But other columns, they do not have any kind of constraints. They might accept the duplicate value and null value. So this way you can use the unique constraint on any column. Next constraint is the primary key. The primary key is very similar to the unique key. Primary key and unique key both maintain the unique value in the columns. But what is the difference between two? The difference is, in primary key, only one primary key is allowed in a table. In case of the unique, you can have the multiple unique constants on multiple columns. Secondly, in case of primary key, it does not allow null value in the column. But in case of the unique, you may have the one null value in the column. So let us check. We have a table that is a create table, demo primary key, and then columns empid, mobile number, city. And this time I make it say primary key. The first rule is, in case of the primary key, the table allows only one primary key. Okay, so we check that rule. I declare, so empid, mobile number, both are the primary key. If I try to create this table, so I get the error, cannot add multiple primary key constraint to table. So this is the first rule. Okay, so we can have only one primary key in a table. Now mobile number, I make it unique. So now we have two constraints, one on empid and another is on mobile number. Empid primary key and mobile number is unique. Now I create this table. Now I execute this statement to insert the data. So we have three: empid, mobile number, city, and their values. So empid is 1 and the mobile number is 2266. Okay, now I try this statement. So I check the data. Now empid 1, mobile number 2626, and the city London. And if execute this statement again, so violation of the primary key, because the primary key is unique. So I change the value for the empid, I make it 2, then execute. Now violation of the unique key constraint, because mobile number is unique and the 2626 is already in that column. Suppose I skip this mobile number. Now I execute this statement. Execute it. Check the data. Empid 1, 2, mobile number, the second column is null. As I told you, in case of the unique, that column can accept the one null value because it's also a value. If I try to say make it 3 and I try to execute this statement again, then violation of the unique key, because the null value is already there in that column, and again null means duplicate null is not allowed. So mobile number, now check data. So this is the difference between the unique and primary key. Both maintain the unique value, but in case of the primary key, it does not allow any null value. You can see in the EMPID, it's a primary key column, and 1, 2, 3, no null value. And mobile number is the unique declared. So we have a unique value including null, but only one null is allowed. So this way you can use the primary. Next constant is check. In the check constant, we can apply condition. Suppose like we want to enter the data for the employees whose age is greater than 40. Okay, so we have a table, demo check, EMPID, then age. Here I make it not null, then check constant. But if you are using the check constant, then you have to mention the condition. Say age, this column, then less than equal to 40. It means when you pass the value for the age, so that value must be less than equal to 40, otherwise it will reject the value. So I create this table. Now I insert the data, EMPID, age, say 45, then I try to insert this data. I get the error, the insert statement conflicted with the check constant. This is the name of the constant created by the SQL server. The next statement is the conflict occurred in a database, my database table this one and column age. Means you have a constant on the age, because of that the data was not validated according to your check condition. So SQL server rejected that data. Now if I supply the value for the age, say 35, then it's gone. Now I check the data. Now we have the data, EMPID, A35, city, London. So this way you can use the check constants for any kind of condition. And next constant is the default. Default means what? When you create a table and declare the columns, that time you can assign some initial value, or you can declare some default value for that column. It means at the time of the entry of the table, if you do not pass the value for that column, then system will take the default value. How? In this table, demo default, we have EMPID, then next is gender, where care 15, not null. Suppose you do not pass gender in the insert statement, and I want some default value, say male. So here I can mention default, then male. Secondly, join date. If you do not pass the join date in insert statement, so I want system should take the current date time. Then here say default, that is a SQL function. Now I create this table. Table created. I insert the data, say only EMPID. Then values say 1. Execute this statement, check data. In EMPID we have 1, and gender it's a male, because we did not supply or we did not pass the value for the gender, so it took the default value as male. And same way in join date, there is no column and there is no value, So the system took the current date time. Suppose if you pass the value for these two columns, then what happens? Say gender, then join date, female, and so this time I'm passing the value for gender and join date both. Now check the data. So you can see this time the system took the female and the date whatever you passed. So default value works when you do not pass the value for that column, then system will take the default value. If you're passing the value, actual value, then system will skip the default value. So this way you can use the default value constraint. Next constraint is the foreign key. It's very important because this foreign key constraint create a relationship between the two tables, and relationship is the one to many. Those table could be say parent table or child table, or you can say primary table or foreign key table. In foreign key table, one foreign key refers the primary key of the primary table. Here we can see the example. We have a two tables. That's a demo primary key. In this table we have the EMP ID and it's a primary key. Second table is the demo foreign key. We have the EMP ID, sale date paid, and paid date. So this EMP ID, here is the syntax. We say foreign key EMP ID, this one, references table of this name, and same EMP ID. So to use the foreign key, first of all, we have to check the data type of both column, because this EMP ID is referring EMP ID of this table, primary key table. So data type of these columns must be same. This is the INT, INT. And this is called the master table. So we can have only the unique entry in this table. But for those unique entries, we can have the multiple related entries in the demo foreign key. It means when you enter the data in foreign key, the system will check if the reference exists in the primary key. If does not, then it will reject the data. Secondly, if you delete the data from the primary key table or master table, so system will check if the reference in the foreign key exists. It means if the related data is there in the foreign key, then it will not allow to delete the data. Now we create the table. First table created, second table also created. So first of all, we try to insert the data in the foreign key. So this is the statement, and we have the EMP ID, salary paid, and paid date. These are the value. If I try to execute this statement, because we are entering the data in foreign key table, and then system will check if the reference, and means this EMP ID, this one, exists in the primary key. If does not, then it will reject the data. So the insert statement conflicted with the foreign key constraint, because there is no reference in the primary key. Which reference? EMP ID. So first of all, I have to make an entry in the primary key table. Say then value 1. If I do this, then done, and now I execute another statement, enter in the foreign key table. Okay, done. Now I check the data in both table. So in the primary key table we have the EMP ID 1 and foreign key we have 1. So this EMP ID is referring the value 1 in this master table. Okay, if I try to insert another statement, say 1, and make it 3, then I change the date, say month, then I check the data again. So EMP ID is the same, okay, salary paid on different month. So this is called the one to many relationship. We cannot have the one duplicate one in this primary table. Okay, If I try to say empid 2, again the same problem, because 2 does not exist in the primary table. So again I insert 2, then now I try this one. Okay, check data. So this is called the primary key or foreign key relationship. And if I try to delete the data from the master table, then what happens? Empid 1, then the delete statement conflicted with the reference. Why? If we check the data, we are trying to delete the empid 1, but this child data, it means the related data, are there in this foreign key table. So the system will not allow us to delete the data from the primary key table. So option is, first you delete the data from the foreign key table, then you can delete the data from the master table. So suppose I say delete from foreign key table, child table, where empid equal to 1. If I delete this one, now I say delete from the primary key. Okay, both executed successfully. If I check the data, so empid 1 gone. So this is called the integrity of the data. Next is the table level constraint. So far we have done the column level constraint, where we apply the constraint on single column. But in case of the table level constraint, we can apply the constraint on multiple columns. Here we have an example. We have a table that is the demo table level. We have ID, teachers ID and subjects. So what we are doing, we are collecting the data of the teachers and subjects stored by them. But we do not want the duplicate entry in our table, teachers wise and subject wise. So what we do, we will make the combination of the two columns, teachers ID and subjects, as unique value. How? This is the table level constraint, so we cannot write with the column, and we write here. This is the constant, is a keyword, constant name, again constant, and this is the columns of the, this is the list of the columns, teachers ID, comma subjects ID. It means the combination of these two columns must be the unique, always in the table. So I create this table, done. Now I try to insert this data, say teachers ID, subject ID. Okay, done. Now I check the data. Okay. So first data is the teachers ID 20 and math, means this teacher is taking the math class. Suppose I change this to, if I try to insert this value again, so violation of the unique key constraint, because in this table the combination of the teachers ID and subjects must be the unique. This combination 20 and math is already in the table, so the table will not accept this combination. Suppose I change English, now insert, done, check data again. Now teacher ID is same but different subject, 20 English, 20 math. So combination is unique. Now try another record, for say 25, and now try this one, done, check. So this time teacher ID is 25, but the subject is repeated, but the combination of teacher's ID and English is unique. So this way you can use the table level constraint. So guys, this was all about the SQL constraints. I hope you understood everything. Thanks for watching the video.